This is a Friday Shoes production. This is lesson 8-7 in our books on page 445, and our target is I can solve inequalities by adding or subtracting. We've been working with inequalities here for the past couple days, and now we're going to be solving some inequalities just using adding or subtracting. Now it says the properties of inequality here. When you add or subtract the same number from each side of any inequality, the inequality remains true. Meaning, if it's less than, it will still stay less than. If it's greater than, it still stay greater than. The best way to look at it is take a look at an example down here. This sometimes is hard to read just because of all the A's and the B's and what have you. So I'm going to skip that spot. Take a look at this example. See how it says 2 is greater than negative 3 right there? Well, then look what they've done. They've added 5 to both sides. When you add something to both sides, if it's the same amount, notice that it's still the left side is greater than the right side. Same with when you subtract. So if you have 3 is less than 8, and then you take away 4 from both sides, negative 1 is still less than 4. So it doesn't change that inequality. It says solving an inequality means finding the values of the variable that make the inequality true. What numbers can you plug in for the variable and keep that sentence true? So let's take a look at this first example. It says solve n minus 8 is less than 15. Then check your solution. So first off, to solve these, it's very similar to solving equations. So you have your inequality. That's what you write down. Step one would be find out what you need to do. In this case, to get n by itself, we need to add 8 to both sides. That will get rid of that minus 8. And then you'll have n is less than 23. Now, any number less than 23 will work in the original inequality. So check that out. We're going to check it by taking a number. It says replace n with a number less than 23, such as 22. You can use any number that's less than 23. Plug it on in, and you'll see that it will still say that that left side is going to be less than 15. So the solution is, and notice it, it's not just a number, it's any number less than 23. So if you think about these, they have lots of solutions. There's lots of numbers that are less than 23. As a matter of fact, there's infinitely many solutions to this. I mean, any number less than 23, not just one answer. And that's how we say it. That's why you have to circle both pieces. All right, how about here? This example, solve negative 4 is greater than or equal to a plus 7. Well, step one, rewrite the inequality. Then look, how am I going to get a by itself? I'm going to have to subtract 7 from both sides. When you subtract 7 from both sides, you end up with negative 11 is greater than or equal to a. Or if you flip that around, notice the inequality gets flipped around too. A is less than or equal to negative 11. So what we would do is to do a check, simply replace a in the original equality with negative 11 and then with a number less than negative 11. And you can see that the solution is A is less than or equal to negative 11. They actually haven't put a number in there, but you can do it on your own and see that it does work out. All right. How about you try these three on your own? Stop the video, then come on back after you're done, see how you've done. All right, it says T plus 3 is greater than 12. Well, step one, rewrite the problem so you have it ready to work. Then I have to get rid of that plus 3, so I'm going to subtract 3. Now I'm going to use the vertical method of solving, meaning I'm not going to put it in the actual line horizontally, and that will cancel out your minus or plus 3. You're left with T on this side. On the right side, 12 minus 3 is, now that's right, that's 9. You bring down your inequality of greater than, and there it is. Any number greater than 9 will work. Let's try 10. 10 is greater than 9. So is 10 plus 3, is that going to be greater than 12? That sure is. 13 is greater than 12. So that checks out. How about the second one here? We have n plus 1 half is greater than or equal to 4. So I would write the problem. And then I'm going to get n by itself by subtracting away a half from this side and subtracting away a half from this side. And then we'll end up with, that will cancel out, n is greater than or equal to 3.5. Now, we could check it by plugging any number greater than or equal to 3.5, like 4. If we plugged 4 in, let's see here, 4 plus 1 half, is that greater than or equal to 4? Sure is. it works out. That checks. 4.5 is definitely greater than 4. Anything that equals 4 would work as well. How about y minus 1.5 is less than 2? Step 1, write down your problem. Then, add 1.5 to both sides to get y by itself. Those cancel out, and you're left with y on this side. The less than, and then 2 plus 1.5 is 3.5. So any number less than 3.5 will work. I'll try 3. So 3 minus 1.5, is that going to be less than 2? 3 minus 1.5 is 1.5. And guess what? 1.5 is less than 2. Now remember, there's lots of solutions. So we circle these as our answers because we have to. It's more of a sentence stating, for instance, this last one. Any number less than 3.5 will work. That's a lot of numbers. All right, let's take a look at this example. It says the Airbus A380 can seat up to 853 passengers. Suppose there are currently 632 passengers boarding on the airplane, or boarded on the airplane. Which inequality indicates how many more people are able to board? Well, we already know that there's 632 passengers on the plane, and we need to add in so many more to get up to a maximum of 853 passengers. So to do this, if you look at how they set it up, they say, you know, make sure you reread the item and make sure you understand what you're doing. It says the phrase up to means less than or equal to 853 passengers. So let P equal the number of passengers left to board. And to do that, we'll take our 632 passengers. Here, I just go right to this level right here. You take your 632 passengers that are already on the plane. You add in the amount that you need to get up to, 853, and you put a less than or equal to that 853. And that's kind of what they're stating here. It says your current passengers plus passengers left to get on is less than or equal to 853 total passengers. Then, of course, you solve it, and you notice it's the number of passengers that can still get on the plane are less than or equal to 221 more passengers. And the answer is C. All right, last one. You give it a shot on your own. See how you do on it. It says a tornado is classified using the Fujitsu Tornado Damage Scale. And that's correct. The F scale is what they call it. An F1 tornado has wind speeds that are at least 73 miles per hour. And F2 tornadoes have wind speeds that are at least 113 miles per hour. Kind of neat. Which inequality indicates how much the winds of an F1 tornado need to increase so it becomes at least an F2 tornado? I don't know, but we're going to find out. Well, let's see. Let's let X equal the wind speed increase, how much it has to increase to get to that F2 level. Now, an F1 tornado is 73 miles per hour at least. So we start at 73. And if it's at 73, how much does it have to go up? You can kind of see I'm saying 73 plus how much to get to, which would be equal to 113 or greater than 113. That would be then classified as an F2 tornado. So the words at least means greater than or equal to. So there's our sentence, our inequality sentence that we're going to solve. So step one would be getting rid of that 73, so we have x left by itself. So let's subtract 73 from both sides. When we do that, we end up with x is greater than or equal to 40. And there you go, there's our answer. So the wind speeds need to increase at least 40 miles per hour, or greater than or equal to 40, to then be registered as an F2 tornado. Don't forget, you can always rewatch the video or look at the examples in the book or take a look at some of the personal tutor videos they have online. And this has been a Friday Shoes production.